welcome to the cage, Michael Imperato. Team Tavis, Nathan, will be back in Grand Prairie, Alberta for the semi-main event, XFFC4. This is for the 135 title. Adrian, we got Michael Imperato, a guy you know very well, making his way to the cage, and we take on Jesse Arnett.
Absolutely. Good training by Michael Imperato for a long, long time. Splinting out down the forehead. He is amped up tonight, let me tell you. Trying to calm him down. That's no problem. Doesn't look like that one.
One of the more polarizing personalities in all of MMA. I know he's a very emotional guy, but I also feel a little bit emotional as a guy with a big heart. That guy cares very much for the sport.
Absolutely. Mikey Brown's all heart. He's extremely confident on the ground. This kid has got skill and skill on top of more skills.
That's about how you train with him. Very good submission style fighter. I know he's coming in here. The type of fighter that he would know very well, not just the wrestler. So, there's a very good chance that Imperato might spend some time on his back this evening. But that being said, that might not be a bad thing for him.
No, and that's exactly it. You know, my game plan with everyone is basically the same. It's simple. Keep it where you're comfortable and make your opponent feel very uncomfortable. So, I mean, Jesse Arnett's going to want to play the top game. Mikey's fine with being off his back. Mikey's aggressive there. Mikey's a dangerous there, person there. And Jesse Arnett, you know, he's going to feel quite strong on top as well.
When you look at this fight on paper, Imperato's coming in with a 6-win-1-loss record. Arnett's coming in with a 3-3 record. So, if you're a guy that goes by stats, you might be thinking Imperato's a heavy favorite. However, that's definitely not the case tonight.
No, absolutely. I mean, and everything can be augmented when you look at it on paper. 6-1 by Mikey Imperato. A lot of submission wins. Jesse Arnett's record is 3-3. I don't think that's a true depiction of actually how tough Jesse Arnett is. And again, like I said, I always got to go with how tough the wrestlers are. So, I expect a great, great night of fireworks between these two.
And
here's
the opponent, Jesse Arnett. And here is that opponent making his way to a cage. Very talented wrestler, Jesse Arnett.
Absolutely. He's long, he's lanky, he's strong, he's technical. And I'm telling you, like most wrestlers, he's rugged. He's ready to go 25 feet. And that's what I think is going to be to his advantage. If he's a true game player and if he's a smart guy, again, we all know what he is, he's got a good shot here. If not, he's going to get caught by Mikey Imperato and he's going to get broken off.
That's a very intriguing fight. A lot of people know Imperato from the reality show that he was on with a couple of, teammates in Albania. And there's some bad words that overshadowed a lot of the stuff that happened in that show. But when you got to see Imperato, you definitely knew how good a talented fighter he was.
Yeah, and I mean, I think that's all the facts, all the history. Mikey Imperato was, like I said, one talented kid. It's all full of heart. He's all here for the sport, and he's just a great kid. And I think tonight's fight with Jesse Arnett is a dream come true for both of them, actually.
And with Arnett, you got that very technical, very strong wrestler. It's 135 pounds. You know, it's not the weight that's going to make a good wrestler, it's the technique that's going to make a good wrestler.
Oh, absolutely. Not to mention, he's a big 135, and he's a tall guy for 135. So this is a guy who's got weight, and I believe he wrestled the Nationals at 142 or 143. So for him to get even further down to 135, that's pretty tough. So he's been coming that game pretty big guy.
Yeah, 5'9" for a 135er is quite tall. No doubt about it. Well, we're going to see a very intriguing matchup. It could go quick, it could go the full 5 rounds. And when you got a 5-round title fight, cardio could be a huge factor.
Oh, 25 minutes at all.
Thank you.
5-minute rounds, and is for the XFFC Bantamweight Championship. The man in charge of the bell rings is your referee, Mr. Andy Socio. Introducing first to my left in the blue corner, he comes in at 5 feet 9 inches tall, weighing at 134.2 pounds, with a professional MMA record of 3 victories and 3 losses. From Calgary, Alberta, Jesse Big Cat Arnett. And introducing the planet across the cage in the red corner, he comes in at 5 feet 7 inches tall, weighing at 134.8 pounds, with a professional MMA record of 6 victories and 1 loss. Representing Extreme Couture from Woodbridge, Ontario, Michael Imperato.
Both opponents into the cage, in the center, getting final instructions.
Touch
gloves, back in the corners they go. It is five-minute round title fight at the 135-pound weight class. The Big Cat is in the stance, ready to pounce. Imperato looking pretty relaxed in the corner.
Looks like Jesse Arnett's ready to go. However, it's Imperato that comes across the cage. That big overhand right just missed, thrown by Imperato.
Nice takedown, nice takedown by Mikey Imperato. Looks like he's gone for a back control. Back to a front headlock position. And the Big Cat comes out on top. Mikey Imperato spinning, looking for that calf switch. No, now he's in that heel hook position. Imperato, nice. Good at grappling here. Looking to get that front headlock position again. There he is.
Imperato looks that much quicker than you so far early on in this fight, Adrian.
Yeah, it's been, these guys have been non-stop scramble right from the start, and that's what you expect from the 35ers. You know, they're non-stop action. Looking to jump into that movement part. And that's really looked fairly tight by Imperato.
Yeah, we don't have the best angle right now. It definitely looks deep, however.
You know where Arnett wants to be.
And it taps out. Jesse Arnett taps out. And Michael Imperato is the new XFC Bantamweight Champion.
There you go, 7-1. That's not where you want to be when you're dry and you're fresh. Mikey Imperato getting in that guillotine choke. Not where Arnett wanted to be.
And with that, early in the fight, the fighters haven't been had a chance. You know, there's no sweat on him. The lubrication's not there to slip that handle.
That's exactly it. That's exactly where Imperato wanted to go. And he did an excellent job at implementing his game plan. Good job by Mikey Imperato to be the new XFFC Bantamweight title holder. Very impressive W by Mikey Imperato.
Seconds of the very first round after Jesse Arnett taps out due to guillotine choke, the winner of this match and the new XFFC Bantamweight Champion, Michael Imperato. Bright Fight fans, I'm here with the winner, Michael Imperato. Michael, look across that cage. Look at that belt that's about to go around your waist. I know you want to grab this, Mike. You got some people you want to thank, I'm sure, and then we'll talk about the fight.
First off, Jesse Arnett, real tough guy, really good wrestler. A lot of respect to him. Everyone give him a hand. Thank you for taking the fight. I had another opponent who pulled out just at the last minute. I appreciate it. Darren, from Sense of Force, you went a great show. Thank you so much for this opportunity. You did a lot of work for you. Give me a fight. Really appreciate it. This is a beautiful show. Thank all you guys for showing your support. Wasn't for you guys, none of this would be possible. So we keep living our dream every day through you guys. Sam Sakula, Misha Serkinov, Jay, Rezo, all my boys. Great dog. Everyone came out. My beautiful girlfriend, Chantel. Everyone showed support from Toronto. Thank you so much. Grand Prairie is our first time here. It's a great city. I love to fight here again. We got some top talent out here. I love to break their faces. Show them out. Greg Pfeiffer. Man, where you at, bro? I know you're supposed to fight, but step it up. You know, don't want to lead. You got a lot of tough guys out here, but whoever's next, I got a title. Come grab it.
All right, Mike, let's talk a little bit about that fight. Looked like you came out ready to go full, you know, I'm sure the cardio was there to go five rounds. However, you looked that much quicker tonight than your opponent. Was that the game plan coming in, just push the pace?
I'm 6-1, you know, I want to be the UFC real soon, so I've been putting in hard work. I'm going to do everything I can. Hopefully, Darren helps me get there with this great show. And I really appreciate my teammate, Adrian Williams, for the fight today. Our title's opponent pulled out. It's a tough-ass, badass dude, so hopefully get to see him fight next. He's the flyweight champ, I guarantee you that. My boy Misha Sirkunov, he's a man at 205, so someone has to step up and fight him too. He's a great show to watch as well. Thank you, everybody. Thank you all for coming out. Love everybody.
But we're actually going to talk to Misha very shortly. But Darren, you got some job to do. Let's put that belt around this man's waist. He's the new XFFC Bantamweight Champion. Let's give it up for Michael Imperato.